This is Coleman. He loves beefing things up and watching them explode. This is Pagey. He's a motor mouth with an eye for detail. And their wits, brains and talents are about to be tested in a classic face-off. It's early Saturday morning, and these two weekend inventors are about to be given an ordinary household appliance. They have 48 hours to try and make it bigger, better, faster, and stronger.
Mailboxes. Mailboxes. What can we do to improve a mailbox? I mean, let her in, let her out. Here we go, Pagey. You have mail. All will be revealed. This mailbox is the most technologically advanced model on the market. It's impervious to virtually all climatic conditions, but going to the mailbox uses precious energy that could be better used drinking scotch or eating bujja mix. You'll be challenged to see who can deliver the mail from the mailbox to the house 50 metres down the driveway in the fastest time. Good luck. That's a cool challenge.
To help them build their mailboxes, Pagey and Coleman have to choose some team members, each of whom have some awesome handy abilities that will help them with their inventions. Except one, the wild card, whose particular skill is not at all helpful. This week, there is a rocket scientist, a mechanical engineer, a master fabricator, a builder, and the wild card, a racing driver.
Okay, I'll go.
I like that, man. Let's have him. Let's see what I got. Racing driver. Fantastic.
My skills generally are driving fast around a racetrack, so I'm not quite sure what you're saying I'm going to be to the team.
I'm going to go for the gentleman in the centre, because he's quite intense. Just, like, he hasn't blinked since he's been here.
Yeah.
Master fabricator, welcome.
Stainless alloy, MIG, arc. So anything that requires fabrication, welding side of it, it shouldn't be a problem.
You look like a sciencey sort of man. I'm going to have you on my team.
Basically, he called you a geek.
Yeah. A rocket scientist.
You really?
Absolutely.
Fantastic. Wow. Welcome to the team.
I enjoy the engineering challenge. Rocket propulsion is I guess, at the peak of engineering.
The older gentleman here.
Take the,
he's got an
age.
Intense sort of look about him. Yeah, and he's got dirty hands, which means a lot.
Mechanical engineer. Yeah.
My passion is design. I love design. I love making things quality and come through, make it work.
What do we miss out on? Builder. You would have been quite useful. Never mind. That's all good. Welcome to the team, guys.
Right, dudes, you like it here. It's tidy.
The teams now only have a weekend to develop something that can deliver the mail 50 metres in the quickest time possible.
So how fast can you do it in a race car?
Just shy of 300.
300 kilometres an hour?
Yeah.
So,
I would say probably 3 to 5 seconds.
I guess the only thing will be, because it's just mail, it's paper. Do we send just the paper, or do we send the whole box?
What if you were to have an inside container and you make a hole on the back, so that stays where it is, and the container flies back to the home?
That's a good idea.
How fast are you doing a rocket, Peter?
Mark 1, greater than the speed of sound. Be 0 to 50 metres in under half a second.
Sold.
Done.
Yeah, I can't compete with that one.
You know when you go and get a warrant and you drive, they put your car on that thing that tests the brakes?
Yep.
Yeah.
The roller.
What's it called? Like the rollery things that the car goes on? And let's go for a drum gondolier cable-a-tron.
So we need a rail of some description.
Okay.
Then we need a rocket and light it up, go along the rocket rail to maintain our trajectory, and then we need to think of a way to stop it.
Coleman is in his element. His mail will be delivered by a rocket. The mail will be placed inside the rocket and will then fly along a wire cable, keeping it on course and travelling faster than the speed of sound. Upon delivery to the house, the rocket will then be stopped by a water bath.
So you've got your pulley, which is this coming down to that?
Yeah.
Through the centre of this pulley?
Yeah.
Transferring your rotational force through a shaft to your second pulley. And from that second pulley, which will be the one...
Boom.
To that point there.
And the only thing, and then if we want to bring the...
Pagey's idea involves a little less fire. They are going to create a wire pulley system powered by the wheels of a car. The wheel will sit on two drums. As the wheel rotates, it will in turn spin one of the drums. The drum will be attached to the wire pulley system, which will move as the drum spins, picking the letterbox up and taking it to the house. Having decided on their designs, the guys get into writing up a shopping list of parts they need to get.
You need some gunpowder, or no, what you call it?
Liquid nitrous oxide. Liquid. For the oxidizer.
This is a long list, man.
You miss a detail on a rocket, she's all over.
Go, Peter.
Coleman's team is first out, and Peter is off to his lab to pick up some rocket stuff. Because it took them a while to figure out the finer points of their pulley, Pagey's team are second out.
I think we chose the right guy for driving. Come in here, bro. Let's go.
While the parts are being collected, the teams can do nothing but chill out.
Do you actually understand any of that?
Uh-uh.
Where are you from?
From Holland.
Holland, so that's Dutch.
900 kilometres an hour.
The guys hear a ute arrive and scramble to see who's first back.
Awesome. Good man, Peter. Good timing. What's that?
Carry that like your life depends on it.
While Coleman doesn't know what the pink stuff is, he instinctively carries it in with care. Pagey can do nothing but hope that James drops it.
Just be a bit careful with that stuff, James. She's a little bit shock sensitive. What about, the skipping game, double dutch?
Double dutch?
No, we just call it double.
I'm missing you there.
Is that part go on the rocket?
Yes, sort of. We strip this to bits and take out some of the valving, and we bury that inside this pre-combustion chamber where the injector goes.
Okay.
And then we weld that onto the combustion chamber, and then we've got a nozzle and weld that on.
Right.
And we've got this and this.
Okay.
And then we pour the propellant inside.
Yeah.
And we're good to go.
Okay. First of the frame cuts.
Just remember, James, make everything you do a work of art. Because if it looks like crap and doesn't work, you've got nothing. But if it looks great, at least it looks great.
Good.
An hour later, Jono returns, and Pagey and Gerard are eager to get the stuff in and begin building.
Dude.
He was quite late with the ute, and we were all in a hurry, and while Greg grabbed his tray, it snapped off as well, so we had a delay. All the parts were on the floor.
I broke the box.
I don't know why he got the tray inside while all the parts were still on the floor, so I got the tray outside again to put all those parts in.
Don't tell anyone.
What's in the sack, man? It looks like some kind of poaching.
We have some tubes in here.
So these can be for our drums?
Rollers, yep.
Won't it be slippery?
Yeah, we'll have to put some, we'll run some welds along there, give it a little bit of traction on the tyres.
Coleman and Jono start to build the frame that will support the thrust of the rocket. But Coleman is proving to be more of a hindrance than a help.
Nice hole, James. I think we might need to quieten the welder down a bit.
Pagey's team haven't started building and are still figuring out the finer details of their design.
Well, that's something this size, whatever it is. You can imagine it sliding in.
Yep.
It lines up with the slot of the box. We open the top so the mail will fall in.
Yep.
Then slide back to the house. We have the cable on here. We've got an arm that's hanging from the cable that will get it into position here.
We could call one male and one female, but spell them like male. You know, like...
Oh, and fear is coming over.
But communication amongst the team isn't the best.
Right. Yeah, sure. Yeah, we can do that. Like, yeah, that's a good idea.
Male? Like...
Ah, yeah, got it. Male. Okay.
What are you actually doing, Peter?
I'm just marking out some fins and doing some calculations to make sure we get this rocket statically stable, because we need it to follow its trajectory, otherwise we've got a real problem on our hands.
Pagey's team have worked quickly and have managed to construct the carry system for their mail.
Mate, check it out. I made a test letter.
Good.
Let's post it.
Now they want to see if the pulley works.
Okay. You can hang it on here.
Contact?
Yep. Inserting in the pulley now.
All right, hang on.
You okay? Pull the pulley.
Yeah. Are you ready?
Mail.
Ready?
Go.
Mail coming to you.
Yep.
Now.
Bring it. Oh, stop! Hey!
Did you get it?
Hang on.
Awesome, it worked.
Dear Greg, you're awesome. We love you. Thanks from your team. Oh, and thanks, guys. I appreciate that. Hey, look, I'll send some return mail to you. Mate.
That seems to work okay.
Oh, that is amazing.
We'll see what happens on the day.
So if that's one drill, how fast is the car going to do it?
Pretty quick.
Well, you guys rule. That is, I'm so happy.
Oh, yeah, it was just fun, really. Big fun.
Pagey's pulley works, but they still have a lot to build and get straight into constructing the rollers. The teams have been working for half a day, trying to make something that can deliver the mail 50 metres in the fastest time possible.
We've got a rocket. How can we lose?
Some teams are working better than others.
Pagey. Yeah. He's got a, definitely got a very good creative streak in him.
Woo!
How you going there, buddy?
Oh, yeah.
In the other shed, the rocket is ready to put together. Coleman is chomping at the bit.
Awesome.
James?
Wow.
Very, very nice.
It's where the mail goes, right?
That is correct,
yep. Normally that'd be anthrax in there, but we're going to put bills in there.
You know, it's a rocket, so there's very little margin for error. Although we've tried to make it as industrial as we can, there's still, you know, a tremendous amount of power and forces involved.
What's that put there for?
That's our sting. So when we go through the sound barrier, we want to purposely propagate a shockwave. So we don't want the shockwave to attach in various appendages on the rocket. We want to find a point for the shockwave to attach. Whereas if the shockwave attaches on the back of a fin or back here, it's going to throw some aerodynamic pressures out on the rocket.
Looks really cool.
Awesome.
But Pagey's team are working fast and have finished the rollers that will transfer the speed from the car to their pulley.
Car comes up here, wheel goes in here, hits this, then sits on here.
Yep.
This is the drive, so the car will be going that way. Wheel spins the pulley. Cool. Jared.
Pagey is very happy with the speed of his team's build and is quietly confident. He pays a visit to Coleman's shed to gloat.
That's right, Pagey. We are building a rocket.
Hey. So, what are they doing?
We're good, man. We're real good.
Yeah. How do we beat a rocket? Maybe our one might be a little bit more reliable, a little bit more controllable.
What is the winning? What is the challenge? Do we go first or do we have a reliable system? You know, one of the things that we can do, we can return the mailbox and reuse it. I think they can't.
All right, so we need to cut this in half lengthwise so we can make a water bath to stop the rocket at 1 mach. Actually, what we'll do is we'll cut the top off. We'll cut across the top. Woo! She's on fire. Yeah!
We need at least 4 metres to be able to decelerate it. So
maybe another 2 drums in.
Yeah. 2.
Give us 4 metres.
Still getting over the shock of competing against a rocket, Pagey's team soldier on and are ready to test their roller system. They want to see if it will support the car's weight and spin freely enough to work the pulley.
Yep. A little bit more. Perfect.
Yep.
We go.
Okay.
Jono,
it's now time to see how fast they can go. Pagey will be measuring the speed of the spin using a tachometer.
Oh, hold on! Why is it jumping off?
The front one is seizing up. One of the rollers did not have enough clearance between the sidewall, and it just bit into it. You know, it was rubbing.
Nah, it's gonna. It's biting. So if we push more of the weight back and run it in reverse, it'll probably work.
What are you doing? What is?
We're finished and we're just making something now. Just have fun. So, what are you doing?
Maybe we had a slight miscalculation on tolerances against the metal. Had a little bit of binding there. It's not a big deal. We can sand the rollers. I can't see it being a big problem.
Is that just a clang, zit, zit, fixed? Nice.
Meanwhile, Coleman and Jono have finished putting together the water bath, which will be used to slow the rocket down.
Remember we had that conversation right at the beginning, James? Make everything you do look like a work of art, because if it looks like crap and it doesn't work, it looks like crap. Wow, let's just hope it works.
Nice work.
Let's see what's happening now. Now we've got our rocket here, coming in at Mach 1, hopefully, and then we come in and we impact this polystyrene, which will then disintegrate.
Yep.
and then we'll come scooting in here, and we'll be decelerating at around about 200 Gs. So we'll go from Mark 1 there to, hopefully, zero here.
Great. And we'll put this thing on legs. It'll be like some sort of pig trough, won't it, really?
It's called an aqua decelerator.
It's an aqua decelerator.
Rather than a pig's trough.
Yeah.
With their aqua decelerator finished, so Coleman's team are ready to test the ignition.
How explosive is that? I mean, if you dropped that, what would happen?
No, safe as houses. It's a non-detonating explosive, so it burns, it doesn't explode. We just throw a whole lot of heat flux into the combustion chamber along with the oxidizer and the fuel, and that's what starts and propagates our ignition.
Okay, cool. So are we ready to go?
To stop from catching on fire or being severely burned, the team cower at the back of the shed.
Okay, so now we want to take the firing box.
Oh, I'm getting a little bit excited here.
Because it sets the rocket in motion, everything relies on this ignition working.
Arm. 3, 2, 1, fire.
That was mean.
When the igniter test kicked off, I was pretty impressed. I've got a lot of confidence in Peter because he's a bit of a whiz, and without him here, we would have no chance.
Wow.
That was 30 newtons of thrust. The rocket that we're doing down there tomorrow is 3,000 newtons of thrust.
Fantastic.
Work continues in Pagey's shed to try and figure out a way of connecting their pulley to the house. And with Coleman's rocket built, his team still have to build a sturdy frame that will be able to support the rocket's thrust.
Yeah, see what I'm saying? Oh yeah, now who's the hard bugger?
They both work into the night to get ready for the big challenge tomorrow. It is the day of the big challenge, and the teams have their inventions ready to go. They must get the mail delivered from the mailbox 50 metres to the house, into the hands of their loving wives.
You never want to get too confident, but unless they've got something more powerful than a rocket, I think we will be all right there.
I don't think sheer speed of our machine's going to compare, but you just don't know what's going to happen, really.
They have to do this as fast as possible, being timed and judged by the adjudicator.
I love what you've made. I think it's, you know, it's very chitty chitty bang bang. It's kind of cute. It's kind of funny.
It works. It's reusable.
Yeah,
friendly to the environment.
I mean, ours is a rocket.
Granted that making a rocket is cool. I mean, every boy wants to make a rocket, and these guys were kind of bummed out when they saw the rocket. But it's a piece of paper.
Are you saying that when we get to the end of the thing,
there'll be nothing,
there'll be nothing left?
There might be a rocket, but there'll be no mail.
Well, we'll see about that.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah, you know.
Paper, rock, scissors. Ready? Yep. Ah! Whatever. It's kind of fun to watch you guys.
Sign up.
Cool.
To come right.
Both teams will start at the house and be counted in by the adjudicator. It is a race.
Team Pagey, on your marks. Get set.
Ready, grab on, go! Let's go! Woo! Yeah, bro! It's good! It's really good! Wait up, wait! Bring it back!
Thirty seconds have passed as Pagey delivers his letter.
Go, mate, go! Just slowly.
The container leaves the mailbox well.
Oh, yes!
But the pulley has come off the wheels, costing Pagey's team precious time.
Oh, that's because someone took it off.
The container he designed out of jealousy to look like
sir.
A rocket is now not moving.
Yeah, don't put the belt on yet.
They get it back on. But now the car wheel is slipping over the metal drums. Pagey has to push the back of the ute to make sure the wheel connects properly with the drum.
Yeah, the belt's still on. The belt's still on. Man, I'll never have to push a car so much. Check it out, it's working! Yes!
Oh, yeah!
In the window! Boom! Yes! And into her hand!
Pagey's mail is successfully delivered. Straight to the house, their design has worked. But now it's time for the rocket. The only thing that can stop it working is a faulty ignition.
Team Coleman,
like trying to time that on a stopwatch.
On your mark. Get set.
If the rocket backfires or flies off the supporting wires, then it could be fatal. Jono, the racing driver, beelines to the bomb shelter for safety. Everyone else follows suit.
Five, four, three, two, one, fire. Yeah!
The rocket is a success, breaking the speed of sound.
Yes!
Awesome!
Well, it stopped.
Look what it...
It stopped.
There's my lady friend's skirt. And we delivered the mail, boys.
We did indeed.
That was something else. Check it out.
There's your nose wire down
there. Yeah, the sting there. We have suffered some slight structural damage, but not too bad.
And we delivered the mail.
There is the mail.
There it is.
Yep.
Ah, that was great. Let's do it again. I love it.
The results, gentlemen. Right, so Paige's team delivered the mail in 2 minutes, 37 seconds. Coleman's team delivered the mail in 1 minute and 10 seconds.
Woo! Awesome. Yes.
That well, it's
going to win.
However,
can't beat a rock.
Coleman's team completely destroyed the mail, which means Paige's team won.
Yes!
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 Destroyed the mail. The mail was there. The invite was
shake
right
hands,
there.
Shake hands. Nice work. I want to give you a big.
Yeah, talent.
Oh, ow. Bro.
Yeah.
That was super spectacular, really. I mean, that was so impressive, and I actually thought you were going to win. But
you knew we'd win. You knew we won all along. The thing
it was a flawed idea, bro.
It was a charity. We had a rocket.
Dangerous, man.
And you guys put a lot
you
of
still
effort
rule,
in.
Though, big man.
You still rule.
But you rule more. And you. Now we're going to put our girl back together.
I don't believe this.
Oh, that was so good.
It was less than a second, but whatever.
This is Coleman. He loves beefing things up and watching them explode. This is Pagey. He's a motor mouth with an eye for detail. And their wits, brains and talents are about to be tested in a classic face-off. It's early Saturday morning, and these two roughshod inventors are about to be given a plain everyday household appliance. They have 48 hours to try and make it bigger, better, faster, and stronger.
Waste disposal units.
They're always too underpowered. You should be able to put a teaspoon in there, gone. You should be able to put a carcass in there, gone. Yeah.
Have you ever put your hand in one?
Yeah, it's kind of freaky. Let's have a look.
Yeah, read it, man.
Rubbish is annoying. Thankfully, a great deal of it can be mashed through a waste disposal unit and sent down the drain. You have 1 weekend to make a bigger, better, faster, stronger waste disposal unit. On Sunday, you'll be challenged to see who can get rid of a bag of rubbish in the shortest time possible. Great. It's a good challenge, Pagey.
To help them build their waste disposal units, Pagey and Coleman have to choose some team members. Each one has their own interesting field of expertise that will be helpful to the build. Except one, the wild card, whose line of specialty is not at all helpful. This week there is a fabricator welder, an electrician, a hydraulics engineer, an aeronautical engineer, and the wild card, a magician.
I'm going to choose this guy. He looks really useful. I got him first.
He's got a cool beard too.
Fantastic. Oh. Fabricator welder. Awesome. Welcome to Team Coleman.
Qualified tradesperson. And basically I'm on the team as a fabricator welder.
Mate, you're tall. There's lots of tall stuff in the workshop. I'm actually quite short.
Good.
All right, hydraulics engineer.
Well done, mate.
That's quite good.
Yeah, skills in that are welding, hydraulic knowledge, fabricating.
I like the way this man's standing. He looks like he is a very useful man in a workshop. Knows his way around. Aeronautical engineer.
Me and a mate made a van float and drive it around and in the water and ended up driving it to Wellington from Picton.
Right, last two. That, picking you for the earrings, mate, they are awesome. I hope you fabricated them yourself on your lathe, right? Magician! Yeah!
Dude. That's all good. Well, I've got no idea what I'm doing here, actually. I've never been in a workshop before. Don't know what any of the tools look like.
Hey, what about this young man here first?
Yeah, let's see what we missed out on. Electrician.
Could have been useful.
Could have been useful.
Sorry, buddy.
Still pretty happy.
The teams now only have a weekend to develop something that can get rid of a bag of rubbish in the shortest time possible.
I mean, I'm thinking we actually just physically, you know, chuck it out. You know, like out of sight, out of mind, basically.
What about just using a tank and compressed air?
Yeah.
Just like pump it up.
Yeah, so a massive spud gun, essentially. That's a great idea.
Round the corner, and up here you got your valve.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Coleman is beside himself. His team are going to try and build the biggest air cannon in the Southern Hemisphere. Compressed air will be pumped into a sealed pressure vessel, where it will be directed around a bend to stop thrust. The air will then be let into the cannon via a valve, releasing the pressure and firing.
You think hydraulics, like presses and jacks and rams and stuff like that, right?
Yep. So we can put a ram into a frame and chuck the rubbish in there and squish it as much as we can.
Then what will we make? Logs.
Log, yeah.
Straight up logs.
Fire logs.
Fire logs.
Heat your house with your own rubbish. Good. So that's the bit that comes out.
Pagey's hydraulic press will be lever operated. The head of the press will be housed in a box, creating space for the rubbish. Once the rubbish has been put into the box, a lid will be placed on top and the press will force its way upwards. This will crush the rubbish and create a small compressed brick.
What do we need, Craig?
Air tank.
Having decided on their designs, the guys write up a shopping list of parts they need to get.
Some real high-density polystyrene. Yep.
You can drive? Dude, let's go now. Away you go, man. Away you go. Go quickly. Go safe, bro.
Craig, into town, bro.
Sweet. You go, buddy.
It's unclear, however, if the big man understands there is the small matter of a time constraint.
Go, Craig. Hey, mate. What's up?
And Team Coleman are off, finally, with a hiss and a roar. While both teams wait for parts, they start to familiarise themselves with the waste disposal unit they're looking to improve.
You might as well turn it on, I suppose.
Do it again.
The brightest minds are hard at work. Craig from Coleman's team is first back, and the large cylinders arouse Pagey's interest and a certain amount of jealousy.
It's a waste disposal, not a hot water
cylinder.
Check it
out!
Let's get this in.
Right, let's get into it.
One piece of rope. We take the ends up to the top, and now what we're going to do is take this,
the loop,
the middle. Okay,
the middle?
There goes the ends.
Okay,
there goes the middle.
I
want you to chop that just there. Okay.
Okay, I'm going to cut it.
Yeah. All right.
Ready?
So just chop that there. Now, if
totally
you cut
brutalized
one
there.
Piece of rope, how many pieces of rope do you have?
Two.
Now they need to be even at. Oh, sorry, they're not even. Sorry.
No.
Can I start again?
No.
Yeah. Okay. I'll just start again. One piece of rope. Do you like that one?
Coleman's team start assembling the pressure vessel, which is where the compressed air will be held until firing.
Got a bit of work to do, eh?
So this is the butterfly valve, or the trigger. It's going to release the pressure, I guess.
That's going to look quite cool, actually.
Yeah, man. Hey.
All right.
Dude, that could be us.
That's
Sam. Yeah.
Sam finally arrives back with the necessary parts for their team's hydraulic rubbish press.
Nice work! Hydraulic bad boys. Yes! Yeah, man! Nice work, come on in.
Pagey's team are well behind Coleman's team, who moved their pressure chamber outside for the first phase of testing.
You're right with that, Craig. Very scientific test. All right.
You ready for this?
Go for it.
The chamber needs to be airtight to make sure the pressure, when it's finally expelled, is as high as possible.
Woo! Awesome.
We pumped it to about 10 psi, which is way less than what we thought we'd use it at. And it blew this bucket, like, way down the hill, which was quite a bit more of a reaction than I thought would happen. So looks pretty promising.
Good result. It worked, boys. That's going to shift a truckload of rubbish at 100 psi or more. Beautiful. Oh, that was fantastic. Well, let's stick the elbow on it and put a barrel on it. Let's go.
Coleman's team are off to an incredible start with their design, while Pagey and his team play catch-up, amending their hydraulic presses with some delicate refinements.
Oh, yeah.
Both teams are working hard on their waste disposal units. Their challenge is to get rid of a bag of rubbish as quickly as possible. But Pagey's team are experiencing a half-hearted work ethic from their team captain.
I've got a really big head.
Much to the amusement of his harder working teammates.
Cool, eh? Like sideways.
Are you guys still doing that?
We'll do some grinding now, eh?
The other two guys are messing around a little bit. Make sort of a fun workshop. Justin, he's good. He's awesome. Got some cool tricks.
Seeing about the workshop safety, that's the only thing. I just found this in the bin. Yeah. They go, whoa, whoa, hey, check this out, man. Hey.
Yeah, James. He wanted to put a sight on the front of the barrel.
Do you mind tacking that around about... around about there?
Yes!
Ah. He loves that sight. Loves it.
That's great.
Right.
Check it out.
Bugger off.
Whoa. Set my hair on fire, mate. You put a tick on them if they're good. Well, that ain't all bad.
Coleman is working on a polystyrene wad.
Oh, that makes a terrible noise.
This will form a seal within the tank, building up the air pressure to create a high amount of expulsion to fire the rubbish.
Yep. I think I sussed the handle problem.
OK. What have you got?
So these are the handles that came with these. Check it out.
Hello, yep.
Mate, how you going?
Good. What are you making? Wow.
It's an ergonomic garbage disposal unit that does some exciting stuff that I'm not going to tell you about.
You're going to take an awful lot of time to compress? Compress your garbage?
We'd like to say compact.
Compact your garbage? Yeah. Yours is going to take quite a long time. That's all I'm
just... You always say that, and I'm just cool with
actually,
it.
Actually...
Don't take... Oh, you can have that. Yeah, you
I could
can
have done with that.
You can have it. I made it for you.
Why did I say that? I just spent ages...
Just get out of the shed, man. Get it. Come on. Out.
The sparks are flying as Pagey's team weld, sand, saw and cut their monstrosity into shape. While Coleman and his team ready their creation for testing, aiming to create what will hopefully be the largest air cannon in the Southern Hemisphere.
It is a thing of beauty. Woo! Well done, boys. Oh, I'm so proud of this.
Time is dragging on, and Pagey's team hurry to finish their hydraulic press and test it in time.
Look at this. Pins in the holes. Kind of liking the whole kind of ground metal look.
Looks good, eh?
I want to crush stuff.
Pagey is ready to test his hydraulic rams. These rams use the kinetic energy of liquid to force the rubbish upwards. But his team are keen to see how long it will actually take to do this.
What do you got?
All right, man.
You got... I like the way you put it in.
Banana spin.
Cool.
Spin. Chuck
it in.
You know what that is,
though. Can.
Banana.
Yeah. Apple.
Squash it up, man. Squash it up.
This is my hand sanitizer.
Oh,
yeah. Too bad. Crush it. Chuck it in.
Go.
Right. I'll crush.
What you got?
Do it.
Come on, man.
Show us how it's done.
Let's go, bro. So we chucked everything in, and then, Paige was crushing all up, and it just... took ages, and all the juice was falling out and stuff. I mean, I wouldn't want that in my house.
Oh, yeah. It's rupturing.
Juice is coming all out of it.
What are you doing, Pagey? I've bent the lid. Looks like a lot of work.
Yeah.
What are you going to do with it once it's compressed?
Burn it. Heat the house. Look after the family.
Coming out of there.
It's an
all-rounder.
Recycle.
All-rounder.
Good job, bro.
Can you get me a? We need to.
Hold on. The design of our thing is okay, but it's a little bit slow to pump up in that.
Yeah. I'm not puffing.
No.
It's excitement.
People don't have a lot of time on it.
It's sort of good for hippies and environmentalists, I guess.
Here it is.
That is flat, flat. So we're gonna need a lot more rubbish to make a log.
We need heaps more.
And we need to. Whoa. Keep it coming. Look at that. We made a wafer. Wow, it slightly went down the side, so it didn't make a log. Look at that.
Well, it crushed the can.
Look at that.
Crush anything, man.
Crush Coleman.
Although Pagey is hailing the test a success, it's Coleman who's flush with confidence.
This is the moment I've been waiting for. I'm so pleased to put the wheels on.
Literally lining Pagey up in his sights.
Yep, beautiful.
Okay. She goes, Danny boy. Pagey!
What was that?
Sorry about your door, man. It's all right, come out.
That?
Safe.
What is this stuff? Is that lettuce?
Come on!
It's
check
a
it
big
out.
Gaping
look
cannon.
At that, my friend, is going to get rid of our garbage. Sorry about that, bro. Yeah.
Oh, mate.
You're going to get rid of it? What? Well, compressed air, we've got a massive cannon.
I don't like looking at it.
And we're going to. It's all right, it's completely safe. We're going to pump it out of it. Basically, we're going to shoot it out of the quarry. So we're going to get rid of it.
So you're just littering.
Which yeah, is exactly
basically
what we're
doing. Going to make it someone else's rubbish.
Get
that
rid of the
thing
rubbish.
There is a so statue of to modern human mindsets, which is out of sight, out of mind, which I abhor.
Well, I tell you what, we'll set up a target. OK?
No.
If we can hit the target with our gun...
In one shot?
No.
First shot?
No, five shots.
Three?
Three shots, OK. All right, three shots. We've got three shots to hit the target.
And that will validate you back
and
in the
and that will validate the fact that we can actually fire it into a wheelie bin if we want to. All right?
Yeah. All right. Do it. You won't do it. You won't hit a target with that
good
thing.
On your page.
It's a downpipe with a hot
good
water
man.
Cylinder.
Oh. All right, let's get this thing back inside.
Retiring to their sheds, Pagey's team carries on with the task at hand, coveting Coleman's cannon.
That thing that they're building is pretty cool, eh?
It's real mean. It's awesome.
You'll never hit the target with it, though.
Work continues next door as Coleman's team set about building a bigger barrel to fire off more rubbish.
Beautiful work. I'll just straighten up that site, and I think we're ready for the firing range.
It is the day of the big challenge, and Coleman's team are excited about putting their invention to the test, the largest air cannon in the Southern Hemisphere.
Someone left to ring up Guinness Book of Records or something like that.
Even Pagey's team acknowledge the grandness of the design.
They might have a hard time hitting the target, but even then, their one's just so much better, you know? It's pretty embarrassing, actually.
The task is still ahead of them, though. To get rid of a bag of rubbish as quickly as possible, to be judged by the adjudicator. The trash cannon is impressive and obviously has the power, but does it have the accuracy to hit the chosen target? Or will the fetching powder blue Pagey Mash take the win?
You ready for this, Pagey? One, two,
Yes.
Thank you,
man.
So bad
every
at this.
Time.
All right, good luck, Pagey.
Same to you, mate.
Go hard. And Kev, if you feel like pressing us up a projectile with that thing, go right ahead.
Team Pagey, on your marks, get set, go.
All right, dudes. And back away. Right.
Get a little bit. Yep.
Get that in there.
Jam that in there, man.
Yeah. Oh, man, it smells.
Just got to jam it right in there, Pagey.
Pagey's team encounter their first problem. The hole into Pagey Mash is too small for the rubbish. They settle for a much smaller amount and begin compacting.
Is that tight?
Oh, man.
I can feel that right across my back. The workout's amazing.
Good job.
It's good, man. It's working.
I'm interested to see what comes out the top.
I can feel some pressure.
Yeah, until it gets hard.
Pressure. OK, done.
Cool.
It's done. Pins out.
OK, here's the big reveal.
Cool.
It's better be good, Paisley.
Jacking it up.
Put that on our bench.
I think I've, ruptured some.
Here it is.
Yeah, OK. So this is, what are you going to do with it now?
Oh, a brick.
Hey.
You made a brick.
A brick. Check that out.
One brick of rubbish.
Right.
Next.
Mop. You don't want to burn that.
Okay. Good, that's good.
Paigey, this is taking a long time.
But it's working beautifully. Okay. I can feel pressure in the rod. Yep, that's getting tighter.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Entire morning's rubbish. Crushed in 3 hours.
Hey, boom. I like it.
What's that?
I'm over this.
I'm going to need a shirt 2 sizes bigger on this side, man, after this.
I think you're going to have to give up.
Do not shake my hand. I will crush your hand to dust.
It's just embarrassing, KG.
More!
It's embarrassing.
Although it's kind of working, Coleman worries about the impact it's having on the environment.
That's a perfect log.
That's great.
That is wrong on so many levels.
Right, Paige, it's too smoky, dude. I'm out of here.
With smoke, rubbish juices, and time all increasing, Paige's team abandon him.
That. I mean, you're sure it took a long time, but that, the target, 3 shots, if you miss, this wins, and that'll really get up you, right?
Team Coleman, according to agreement, your time will only count if you hit the target. You have 3 chances. Ready, set, go!
Coleman's team wheel the trash cannon into position. The target is acting as a wheelie bin. If he can hit it, then the rubbish has been taken out.
Should have put bigger wheels on it, man.
All right, spin around there.
Actually, a really drawn-out process.
Put most of it on.
Ooh, what's the margarine for? Ooh.
Okay.
After lubricating their trash receptacle, they plug the cannon with their buttered-up ammunition. Coleman ups the ante by increasing the pressure.
We're up to, 40?
40 PSI.
I can put it 50. Let's let that fill up. All right, cannon's up to pressure.
Good luck, Coleman.
Oh, no, too far. Back.
Oh, mate. That thing is pretty awesome.
All right, reset.
Coleman and his team make slight adjustments to account for the rubbish's trajectory.
Yeah!
Bang on. Coleman's team hit the target with their second shot, the rubbish landing over 100 metres away.
Woo! Paigey! Look.
Yeah.
Right in the blooming middle.
Coleman, humble as ever, is quick to take all the credit.
Oh, mate. Seriously, it was the sight. I mucked around with that sight, but that was the thing, hey?
Right, the results, gentlemen. So, Team Pagey got rid of a bag of rubbish in 4 minutes and 37 seconds. Team Coleman got rid of a bag of rubbish in 1 minute and 47 seconds, which makes Team Coleman the winners.
Yep.
Well,
guys.
A win for Coleman, who now has bragging rights after making the largest air cannon in the Southern Hemisphere.
So close to being a bullseye, but not.
Hey,
can you look?
Oh, get out of it. And that thing, I mean, there's got to be a... Do you know what? It's probably no good in the kitchen, but there's got to be another function for it.
Not quite the bullseye with that.
A crematorium.
Nice magic. What the? This caused all our problems.
True dat.
I never liked this from the start. Inserted.
Pull that up and then jam the trigger all the way down
all
while
the way.
Still holding that up.
I had a slippery hand. Through my splashback. Thanks, man. That actually makes me, I actually quite like that now.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.